Hi there, and welcome to this video on Transactions ZipForm Edition. Today, we'll be going over how to create a new transaction. Let's go ahead and get started. Let's start by logging into the software. Now that we're on the Transactions tab, let's go and click on the New Transaction button. A pop-up window will appear with five options available, depending on what kind of transaction you are making. New listing, new purchase or offer, new lease, new lease listing, and quick e-sign. The process for creating a transaction is the same across all transaction types. For our purposes today, we're going to select new purchase or offer. Now that we've chosen a transaction type, we need to complete the rest of the information. First, we need to enter in the name, which is typically just the address of the property. Let's go and enter one now. Now that we have an address entered, we need to choose the category of this property. In this case, let's go with residential. Now that we've chosen the category, we can set the status of the transaction. By default, it will be set to active, but you can change it here to start from a different position. This section, Select Template, is where you would go to manually apply a template to this transaction. We'll be covering how templates work in a separate video. You can add an image for the property by clicking on Add Image, then uploading one from your device. Now that we've entered all the information necessary to make this transaction, let's click on Save to create it. Once the system creates the transaction, it will open up onto the Transaction Summary page. Let's take a quick look at each of the tabs within the transaction. Our first tab is Transaction Summary, where the majority of the data regarding the transaction will be. Included in this tab are sections such as Property Summary, with information regarding the property itself, Purchase Summary, where information relating to a purchase would go, Buying Side Commission Summary, where information regarding commission on a purchase would go, Listing Summary, where information relating to a listing would go, and Listing Side Commission Summary, where information regarding commission on a listing would go. The Parties tab is where you would enter in each of the individuals involved in the transaction. For example, let's create Buyer 1. You may notice that there is no red asterisk denoting mandatory fields. However, we highly recommend including at minimum their name and email address. Also, if you're dealing with a trust or an estate, put the name of the trust or estate in the top section and the name of the individual representing them in the bottom section. Within Parties, you will also see the Share feature, which allows you to temporarily share the transaction with individuals who wouldn't have access to the transaction, such as a client or the other agent in a transaction. This feature will be covered in another video. The Documents tab is where you can add documents to your transaction. You can add forms from your forms library by clicking on Add Doc and then Add Form. You can add documents from your computer or cloud by clicking on Add Doc, then Browse for Document. You can add a placeholder by clicking on Add Doc and then Create a Placeholder. Placeholders act as a visual reminder of required documents you may need. You can enter the name of the document or use standard name to enter in the name of a form. You can also add a folder to your documents area by clicking Add Folder and entering in the name of the new folder. You can then move your documents in by clicking and dragging them or selecting Move. One important note regarding the document section is that Transaction ZipForm Edition has built-in two-way communication. Information entered into documents will update other areas of the transaction. For example, if I fill in this section of a form for the purchase price, it will also update the purchase price section in the transaction summary with the new purchase price, and vice versa. The Checklist tab is where you can create checklists and tasks to manage your transaction. You can create a checklist by clicking on New Checklist and entering a name. Once you have a checklist, you can create tasks by clicking on Create a New Task. All a basic task needs is a name and a due date, and you're good to go. The more advanced features of checklists are covered in our regular webinar sessions. The Notes tab is where you can add notes to the transaction for your own personal reference. You can create these notes by clicking on New, entering in the text of the note, then clicking on the Save icon. The eSign tab is where you can create e-signature packets of documents and send them to clients for signing. You can begin by clicking on New and then following the prompts. The full process of creating an e-signature packet will be covered in another video. The History tab is a record of all the actions taken on the transaction. You can filter the information by clicking on Filters and selecting the type of activity you would like to view. You can also access the History tab in the Transaction Summary tab by clicking on the See More button under Recent Activity. The Marketplace tab shows some of our partner integrations that you can use to help with your transaction. You'll see that there are corresponding buttons for each one, with link account, claim account, or other options based on the specific partnership. That sums up how to create a new transaction in Transaction ZipForm Edition. For more detailed information, we invite you to check out one of our webinars by clicking on the link in the description.